A buck swope joint.
Buck swope joint.
A buck swope joint.
We're going to have no fans in baseball if they don't turn it around.
What makes you think they're not going to turn it around?
Getting stomped by the worst teams in the league. The Pirates had lost 9 in a row. Detroit was in last place.
What about We Are Family?
These teams are kicking sand in our face. It's like facing the Pittsburgh Lumber Company in the 70s last night. We have no hope against them.
Hey, Boat. Hey, Boat. Hey, Boat. Hey, Boat.
I guess we're not providing quality entertainment. Well, I guess our track record isn't good enough. You know, I'm being a little snarky here.
Just listening and learning.
Jackson was going to the game last night, and I think he would have rather been sodomized by like the 95 Knicks than go to the game.
Oh. I stayed for 2 innings.
Oh, no, you didn't.
Yep.
You had free tickets in, didn't
he
you?
He wanted to watch D-Book and P. George. That's what he wanted to do.
That's exactly right.
He drove all the way down there, paid to park, waited for the game to start, and then stayed for 2 innings.
It was extremely live that I was going to leave before the Cardinals took an at-bat.
Hey, Boat. I guess we're not providing quality entertainment. Well, I guess our track record isn't good enough. You know, I'm being a little snarky here. Just listening and learning.
I don't remember a team in recent years that went through this long of a slump where they looked this bad. It's not, they haven't had a close game in a while. If it weren't for the Miami Marlins, they would be 1-18 in their last, 21 games or so? They're, 4-15 now in their last 21?
Well, they're 36-39, but the Pirates are 46-27 on the year, so you're playing one of the better clubs in the game.
You're playing one of the worst teams in the National League in all of baseball.
Oh, it's 27-46.
They had lost 9 straight.
Maybe they should play the Diamondbacks.
Hey, Boat. I guess we're not providing quality entertainment. Well, I guess our track record isn't good enough. You know, I'm being a little snarky here. Just listening and learning.
I don't know what you do, really. It's such a veteran team, for the most part.
Somebody's getting whack-diddy-whack. I assure you of that. And here's the Tommy Edmonds soundbite that, to me, is a screaming tell on who it's going to be.
I don't think we've necessarily done the greatest job of making a game plan for how guys are going to throw us day by day and working on things pregame that are specifically tailored to prepare ourselves for that. So I think we're going to kind of start to implement a few more of those things into our pregame routines, and hopefully that helps us out.
Oh, man, that's Yikes. Pretty damning.
Yeah.
Who would that be in reference to, the hitting coach?
Jeff Albert.
God, what they see in him, I don't know.
Hey, Boat. I guess we're not providing quality entertainment. Well, I guess our track record isn't good enough. You know, I'm being a little snarky here. Just listening and learning.
The Matt Carpenter extension, I think, confused probably 75% of St. Louis Cardinal fans in the moment. And the Jeff Albert hitting coach move was also something that, in the moment, people were just like, oh, that's kind of surprising. That's John Mozeliak's guy. Okay, this will be interesting. One of the guys who was most vocal about really adapting to his approach is Paul DeJong, and he has had an all-star year and is hitting .310.
He's hitting .157.
Okay, you double it, though.
He strikes out at least twice a night. .157, guy hit 30 home runs a couple years ago.
Because as I was watching that last night, and I don't know what the hell I was doing watching it, but I was, It just it reminded me of kind of like the death rattle before somebody gets fired.
Hey, Bo. Hey, Bo. Hey, Bo. Hey, Bo. Hey, Bo. Hey, Bo. Hey, Bo.
I guess we're not providing quality entertainment. Well, I guess our track record isn't good enough. You know, I'm being a little snarky here.
Just listening and learning. Back it up a bit.
Sick.
Well, what happened was that twice the bullpen didn't hear Mott's name. I don't know if it's noisy, probably real noisy. They just didn't hear.
Mmm.